Sorry, I don't speak bear.
But the good news is, you're about to learn. This new data set is going to use a whole lot of these skills, all of it, all at once. We're going to test whether you've got mastery of all the different skills you're going to be needing when you're using R. For this data set, we'll be looking at the bears data, which can be found in the homework data sets under bears. And you'll notice it has a lot of different things here. We have the age of the bear. We also have the month in which it was measured and the gender. I believe it was 1 for female and 2 for male because that's alphabetical. There's no particular reason for that. And several different measurements on the bear. The original idea for this data set was to see if you could predict the age based off all of the other variables. For example, the size of the head or of the neck, because it's difficult to know the age of a bear unless you look at their teeth, which is dangerous to do. We, however, are not going to be using all these different variables. The only two we're going to be using is age and weight, so the first and the last column. So I give you the rest of the columns at all. Well, number one, this is real data from measuring bears, and so that's cool. Number two, I want you to get used to the idea that data sets can be very large, and that's okay. Your final project is large. Right now, we're only playing with two columns. We can have more later. So we are interested in the age variable and the weight variable. What things you need to do? Find the average. Find the standard deviation. Here we're doing a confidence interval for the average, not a confidence interval for the slope. So you won't be wanting to use confidence for this. It's a different command. Let's make sure that you know what that is and how to do it. Lower bound, upper bound. These two numbers make the confidence interval. Then plot it. Make sure you know what it looks like. Now, I understand that you have 99 tries on this. Surely you could get this question just by guessing, but that's not the way you should do it. Really try to make those actual plots and make sure your plot matches. We also have scatter plots, which is a tool you're definitely going to want to know how to do. Find the slope. However, this is where it gets really tricky. We have zeros in the data set we want to get rid of. As a hint, here's the idea of what the code should look like, but can you get rid of the bears that have a value of zero? You want to keep only bears with an age above zero, and that should change your picture, make it look better because all those zeros will be gone. It'll also change the slope. Once you've got that fixed, find the R squared, find the residual standard error. Here we're doing another confidence interval, same as we did before. But now with the zeros gone, it'll look just a little bit different. Here we're doing a confidence interval for the slope. That's not a confidence interval for the mean. So you don't want to be using t.test to get this one. It's a different command. Show me that you know how to do that one. And then the p-value, which is important for knowing whether a bear's weight changes based off their age. It's one of these choices here. Typically, this sort of homework assignment takes a long time for students to do, but that's mostly because you're still getting used to R and how it works. After you're done, you'll look back and say, I could redo this assignment in 5 minutes. That's not the way it works. So go to it. Hopefully by the end, you'll be feeling a little more comfortable with R.